give ourselves for your cause. Dedicate our lives just to touch the lost. We don't know all whose lives we have touched. We've touched with love. Purging ourselves, we purify that new light we see, but the one that leads from thee. We got to keep on working, even in today's world. Don't stop reaching.
Don't stop.
Gotta keep on believing. Cause here's the reason. For we may never know all the people we have. For we may never know all the lives that we have reached. But we know, Lord, you know, cause our record you will keep. And when the end is finally begun, we will receive a great reward. Wrestle with what I'm supposed to do, because
I vacillate. I had an identity crisis for a long time. Am I a trumpet player that sings, singer that plays, keyboard guy that tries to play? Do I write songs? God said, you don't do any of that. He said, you're a minister. I've given you gifts. Use them. And one of the things that is amazing to me is so few people can relate to what sound really does in their world. And a long time ago, I had, this will probably rock some of your religious thinking, hopefully not, but you know, when Lucifer got kicked out, and they talk a lot about how he went, you know, and went into the garden to tempt Eve. But if you study Lucifer, you know, he was the highest ranking music maker in all of heaven. And God is not an Indian giver. The gifts and callings of God are without repentance. Just because you blow it doesn't mean God takes away your gift. That's pretty cool. So when God kicked Lucifer out of heaven, he still retained the gift of making music. So do you mean to tell me that he went into the garden without his tools? No. He didn't. He set the arena. I wasn't going to do this, but I might as well. He set the arena before he ever said a thing to Eve. Didn't say a word. Hey Eve, as God said, oh, he knows you'll be just like him. Would you like to be like him? Puts a little different spin on it, doesn't it? He didn't just cold talk to Eve. He painted the picture with sounds. That's why she fell. That's why most people in the world fall. They don't know, right? Isn't that right? So, since I am here, yeah, I'm gonna do that. When I prayed about what to do, I heard to do this. There is a fountain filled with love. I'm celebrating it today. Drawn from Emmanuel vein. Sinners lost beneath that flood, lose all the guilty stains, lose all of the guilty stains. Left behind. which flow. When you think about it, there's no comparison. Nobody's on the cross now.
Amen.
It's a good thing.
Amen.
I said nobody's on the cross now.
Amen.
Whenever I saw the film that was a depiction of what happened with Jesus, pain he really went through for us. Hollywood could never portray it. He was not even recognizable. And every sickness, every disease, every sin, he paid the debt for it all. So much of religion misses it. With every drop of blood fell that day, a million tears of pain were washed away. 10,000 times, 10,000 wars, they were won, till there was nothing left to pay. And like the rain that washes earth and air, just like a fountain that's flowing so pure and clear, cleansing hearts and souls and minds of men, tearing down the walls of fear. We got nothing to fear, people. 'Cause Jesus, he paid it. Did it for you, Jesus paid it all. He paid it. wandered into space. A power struggle for the human race. He bridged the gap between mankind and God. And dying with amazing grace. With every drop of blood that fell that day, 10,000 tears of pain were washed away. 10,000 times 10,000 wars they were won, till there was nothing left to pay. And like the rain it washes earth and air, just like a fountain is flowing and clear, cleansing hearts and souls and minds of men, tearing down the walls of fear. Oh, the fear is falling. Ooh, Jesus paid it all. He did it for me. Did it for you, Jesus paid it all. He paid it all, and with every stride, the final sacrifice. Ooh, Jesus. God bless you.